That's the scariest thing to the ego, and the most joyous thing is that in the end accepting that, who you are, who your essence is the gift. You don't have to look for gifts. Who you are is the gift, but it has no past reference point at all. So what does that mean in everyday living? Well, it means that, you know, like I've seen with Nikita in the communities, when people come up, they may think they have a problem, and she'll just kind of sit there and just kind of look into their eyes like, what are you talking about? You know, it's kind of like not being able to get a problem because there's no past reference point. They'll say, you remember, da-da-da, and just, no, I don't. What are you talking about? Or a friend of ours was kept hearing over and over in his mind for like 3 days in a row, give Nikita to David, give Nikita to David. And he finally came up and he said, what does that even mean, give Nikita to David? What does that even mean? And I said, all it means is let go of every thought that you ever had of Nikita. Just come completely blank and open without the sense that you know who she is or who she ever was. Because it's only perplexing when you try to relate using some kind of past reference point. That's where you get into this idea of trying to resolve something. You know, interpersonal relationships are really sticky. Did you ever notice that on this planet? You know? I mean, at some point it dawns on us, like, these interpersonal relationships are really sticky. Like, what's going on here? But it's sticky. It really feels sticky. And the only way that we can get unstuck from the stickiness is to really honestly admit that we can't really judge anything from our past reference points, you know, because that was just a bunch of judgments. And lo and behold, the characters really seem to act it out well, you know. You hold on to a judgment and, oh yeah, I can act that out. I could give you the Academy Award. You want some drama? Oh, it's very convincing. It's like you're at the theater, Shakespeare Theater, and you're in the front row, and it's like, oh, bravo, that was vicious. Oh, you know, like I lost myself in that, but we don't want to lose ourselves in that. We want to know thyself, like the Greek said, know thyself, the real you. So it's kind of fun because that's what our sessions are anymore. You know, we don't really have themes or topics or whatever. It's just a group of people coming together, and then, you know, there's all this joy. And if somebody actually thinks they have a problem, it gets pretty funny pretty quick. Because the problem is like trying to draw attention. The problem is like trying to say, look at me! Look at me, this is serious. This is really serious. And then you've got a whole group of people going. And then, no, look at me, this is serious. I've got a real problem here. And then there's this softness of essence that's silly. And you know how it is whenever you've even joined with someone, when you seem to believe you have a problem and they see that you don't. They just, oh, come here, let me give you a hug. They don't join you and go, oh, that's terrible. Because that doesn't work, you know. False empathy, oh, you poor thing. You know, no matter how many times we were raised with, oh, you poor thing, come here. Or, let's commiserate together. Or, that's terrible, you know. You don't hear that anymore. You know, I notice in our communities, there's just nobody wants to jump in and support a problem. Why would you if you had to take it on yourself in your mind, you know? So this is what we're coming to now. It's just this joyful, it's light. It was a couple days ago where we had something going on in our community and one was seeming to perceive a problem in somebody else, and Nikita just grabbed the one the problem was supposed to be and just was touching his head going, look, he's just a boy, you know, meaning like he's just innocent, he's not that thing at all. Whatever you think you're seeing in him is not there, it's never been there. That's what the essence was. And then the lightness came swirling in immediately because it seemed to diffuse something, but it really wasn't anything to diffuse. It was just, again, to stand in true empathy, to stand in that innocence. And that's a fun life. That really brings it into the joy and the fun. When your whole purpose is to see the truth, see the love, see the Christ. We did a church service recently, wasn't it? Christ be before me, Christ be behind me, Christ be below me, Christ be above me, Christ be to my right side, Christ be to my left side. You know, it was love all around me. It's really the essence of what is real and true. So I'm not going to fight against that. I'm just going to experience that. And it all just came from someone telling a story of driving in a car and having fear, and then that was the answer that came. You see that everything's a reflection of your mind. Like when we were coming, we were flying across on the frontier, and we were just flying into Cincinnati, and one of the people had opened the newspaper. On the back of the newspaper was a weather map, and it had all these like concentric circles of what they're calling like the polar vortex, and I kept looking over it. It's like it's right over Knoxville, and it's just radiating out like giant waves of colored love, purples and blues and some yellow. Greens and yellow was way out in California, but it was all these things. It was right over. She's like, yeah, this is our reflection of our gathering in Knoxville. Isn't it cute that it's on a map, you know? It's like it was all mapped out. And it's like Knoxville was like the vortex. It just like radiated out. And we could just see that. It's like, oh yeah, that's our first stop of our tour. And it's moving south. Oh, so are we. You know, it's just all reflection. Now, that's just reflections of your mind. When you start to interpret everything that you perceive, even weather maps, as reflections of the love in your mind, then that's what this no problem thing is. It couldn't be anything else, you know. And when you think about it, really, cold and hot are not the problem. You know, if it had been that simple, I think we would have tried some other kind of solution, but it's been a perceptual problem, holding on to a false idea of identity. And then this was a beautiful reflection of that. Very colorful, too.